Hello everyone, this is Ann Klemmer from stamperdoc.com and the Master Stamper. We're going to show you in 2 or 3 minutes how to flip your mitten, because everyone's been asking me about this card that the dog and I did recently on stamperdoc.com. How to make those mittens without having to cut them out. We've got a 2-inch by 5.5-inch piece of white cardstock here, and we're just going to punch them out. Actually, we're going to stamp them out in not quite navy. Doesn't matter what color you use. And we're going to use that great mitten punch that matches it. Now we're going to be concentrating on using it upside down because that's the way it lines up on the punch. And I'm only showing you this one because I want you to pay attention to the little borders around it and how close they are to the edge. Because now we're going to go and do that special step to flip it. We're going to start out with the piercing mat, and then you're going to take the piercing tool and then put strategic holes so that you can line it up later. Now I'm putting the holes out so that I don't want them to show in that border, and that's why I had you punch it that one time out, just so that you could see how wide the border is around the mitten. And once you do that and get used to it, you'll be fine. These are the places where I think it's best to pierce your mitten, because you're going to be able to line it up and not have the holes show. But if you do, I've got a plan B for that as well. Now the best thing to do is go and cut it down so that it's one mitten to your piece of cardstock and attach it to a post-it note, and that way you'll be able to handle it when you put it inside your punch. Now you want to line up those holes, but you really don't want to see them, or maybe you just want to see a little edge of those little holes when you're holding it into your punch. You punch it out and look it, there it is, it lines up. But if you do catch one of your holes, like I did at the top of this one, just take your finger and rub it along the edge of the cardstock, and look, you put them together. And if you want to know the truth, look closely. I did better on the one I did backwards than the one I did right side up. So now, if you'd like some more stamping ideas that are a little bit outside of the box, anything to make your stamping easier, come join us at themasterstamper.com, where we improve our stamping one impression at a time.